What's going on, guys? It is your boy Norton Chat, or FaZe, comes with a brand new Black Ops 3 video today. So today I actually put the free run thing in the background. I put the first three maps. I actually have played the last one. I ever played the second or the third one. I actually played them once before putting it in the video. Just, you know, just to get a feel for the map. They're pretty fun. I actually like this. This is actually kind of fun. It reminds me of surfing from Counter-Strike, even though I've never even done that before. But the last one is actually annoying because it's extremely hard. Like the first three are like the third one, like the third level is actually kind of hard, but the last was actually hard and annoying. So I actually want to learn that one and make a video out of it, I think, for when I get back to New York. I'm actually still in Canada, but see, look at me. Oh, I actually got that. Damn. Anyways, opinion on Black Ops 3. A lot of people have been asking me, saying, hey, Rain, what do you think of Black Ops 3? Hey, Rain, I can tell you kind of don't like Black Ops 3. Hey, Rain, whatever. Opinion. Like, what is your opinion? Do you think this game will last? Do you think this game will die out? What do you think will happen with this Call of Duty? Like, is it, you know, Black Ops 2 to you again? Like, do you feel that way? And honestly, if I'm being honest right off the bat, I don't want to be negative about certain games, but I don't get the same Call of Duty feel as I got through Black Ops 2 and Modern Warfare 2, simply because I know the whole boost thing isn't like Advanced Warfare. It's a lot better than Advanced Warfare, that's for sure. I don't feel like I'm flying all game, but I do feel like it's still high enough to not feel like a regular Call of Duty based game. It does still feel a little bit futuristic, a little bit too much for what I like personally. However, the game mechanics, the flow of the game is actually very good. I just haven't gotten too good at the game yet because I haven't played it a lot. I haven't had time. The day after it released, I had to come to Canada, so I haven't had that much time to play the game. But there's certain things where the whole boosting comes into play, like, for example, free run. Very cool for that. Zombies, I actually really like that. If you guys saw my video with Jev and Adapt and Apex yesterday, I actually very much enjoyed doing that. That was very fun for me. I think Zombies was fun. I can't wait to do that again. I'm just a big fan of Zombies. But is the game gonna last? So, montage-wise, this game seems like it's a very montage-capable game. Advanced Warfare and Ghost weren't, mostly because of the way the game was played. Ghost, I think most of that had to do with the coloring of the game. I felt like the game coloring wasn't too nice for, you know, appealing. So I think that's how I usually like to base games. If it's good for montages, usually it's pretty good of a game for me. That's the way I look at it. I don't know why. Not even because I go for montage codes, but that's why I feel like if it's compatible for montages, then it looks really good. So this game is going to be a way better and more wanted to play game than Advanced Warfare and Ghost. You can already tell that. It already seems like that game that people want to play way more. A lot of people are very much enjoying it. But then again, everybody says that at the beginning of every new Call of Duty. It's just how it's always been. People are like, oh my god, it's new. You know, mostly because it's new. And I feel like my expectations are a little bit higher. I don't want to critique the fuck out of the game because, you know, Vonnegut is a good guy. And, you know, the thing is, he does care about what we want, which is great. And that's something that's awesome. It's good to know that there's people like that that actually do care. Like Advanced Warfare and Ghost, it was kind of like the developers, and we just kind of played what they wanted to, and that's why we never played it. But Black Ops 3, I feel like we have more of a say as a community. I feel like if we want something changed, we could get it changed. Nerfed, example, I feel like they're very, very lenient with us, and I love that about Treyarch. Treyarch is a very good company for that. So this isn't sponsored. I know it sounds like it'd be a sponsor, but it's not. This is my honest opinion. I'm not getting paid to do this. I'm not getting paid to do anything. This is my just personal opinion. I don't know why. It's because the way I said that, it sounded like a very like sponsored type thing. But that's a good thing. That's good to know that, you know, they always have our back and they're always looking out for us. And, you know, what we want can change. That's very cool to know. You know what I mean? Our input's actually appreciated and known. So that on that rule, yes, I feel like this game will outdo Advanced Warfare and Ghost, in my personal opinion. I feel like more people want to play the game because, you know, they get a say, they can get things changed, little annoying things, they can get that changed, maybe, if, you know, majority agree with it, of course. That's what I'm talking about, the majority, not just, you know, like, one person that doesn't like the way, you know, your pistol comes out or something, I don't know, you know what I mean? So, I think this game is pretty good. I haven't had the same Call of Duty feel, honestly. I'm not gonna lie. I've been very sucked into Counter-Strike, and that's a big reason to why I haven't, like, been, like, in love with this game. Counter-Strike's a big reason for that, because I'm just really wanting to, like, I don't know, I just feel like that, I'm not saying it's similar to Call of Duty, I just feel like that's my, like, enjoyment level of Call of Duty for me, because, like, when I first played Call of Duty, it's a game I just wanted to know life all day, and that's how I feel about Counter-Strike. But Black Ops 3 is fun. I like it. A little bit harder to get good at as most Call of... It's harder than most Call of Duties is what I'm trying to say. So that's pretty good, actually. But, you know, it takes a lot more time and effort and everything. Just one thing I'll never be able to get past is the whole robotics thing. I'm not a fan of the whole robot, because when I play Call of Duty, what I want to feel is I want to feel as if we're playing a war game. You know, I want to feel like it's, I'm not talking World War II. I feel like that's a little bit too old for me. Like, World of War was a good game, but Modern Warfare 2 and Black Ops, actually, Modern Warfare 2's setting was perfect for me. That was like the perfect, you know, setting of time, in my opinion. Black Ops 2 was a little bit futuristic, but like, just enough, you know what I mean? But not so it wasn't like forced or overkill or anything. It was like perfect. Other than that, I feel like this game, you know, obviously just it's still new. You might as well just call it still. I mean, it's the final game, but they're still working on stuff. They're still gonna change stuff probably, mostly to do with nerfs and patches and everything. Maps, I feel like they could change a lot if they brought back some good maps, because it is a playable game. Like, they brought back High Rise on Advanced Warfare, but still no one really wanted to play that because, you know, the game, it's all about the game. I mean, I'm not saying, this is my opinion, you know? If you love it, then, you know, that's your thing. I'm glad you enjoy a game. That's awesome. But I feel like if they return maps like Raid, I was about to say Skid Row, Standoff, if they return maps like those, like, popular maps, Studio, once again, they could really, really, you know, have people to want to play it even more. But I think they should stick away from the future thing. Like Nuketown, for example, too futuristic, in my opinion. Way, way, way too futuristic. A little bit too much, you know what I mean? It's like, it's Nuketown, but it's too futuristic. So if they were to bring back Studio Raid or whatever, I just hope they don't make it look like, you know, the Jetsons family's, like, backyard or something. You know what I mean? They gotta make it feel like a Call of Duty map, a war map. And I think that's what most people want to play. But opinion, will it last? I feel like yes, it will be a playable game. It won't be a game that everyone stops playing. It's going to be a game that, you know, I don't think that it's a game that everyone's going to drop everything else for. I don't believe that, in my personal opinion. But, you know, you guys might surprise me, the community might surprise me, that might change. But I feel as if it's more of a playable game than Advanced Warfare and Ghosts. Obviously, I just feel like most of our standards were so high because the last two games weren't the best. Some people might like them, but the majority didn't like the last two games. So I think that's why our standards for, like, you know, the game is a little bit... Fuck, I'm so pissed right there. But that's why I think our standards was, like, so much higher for, like, a better game. It's because, you know, we were hoping for, you know, something ridiculous. And it is a really, really good game, but there's just certain things that irk me, I guess. And that's the whole futuristic aspect. But that's just my opinion, because that's what I personally enjoy. Other than that, it's a good game. I can see they took their time with it. I'm glad they tried adding a lot of new stuff. And I just hope that they, you know, work even more on it and add more things that most people would enjoy. Because, you know, at the end of the day, of course it'll sell. But it's about keeping those happy, loyal customers that just love Call of Duty. You know what I mean? That's what they got to keep. And that's just the way, you know, you can make a game if nobody likes it. People are going to be less, you know, wanting to buy the next one. You shouldn't want that. You should want everybody to always want to, because they're so excited for the next one, because they know it's going to be good. So I think Treyarch has that under their mind. I'm pretty sure they started developing it before they realized what the feeling of Advanced Warfare was, because they did have 2 years for it. So they started modeling the maps off the boost stuff. But I feel like maybe, I don't know, but I feel like maybe if they were to try it again, they wouldn't have included the, you know, boost stuff. But then again, it wasn't too bad. Look how hyped I was right there. I can't believe I got that. But anyways, that is my opinion on the game. I do think it's a good game overall. So thank you guys for watching the video. Please drop a comment if you do agree or enjoy the video at all. It has been your boy, Norton Shatterface. I want to just keep it real. You guys are the best. Love you guys so much. Take care, guys.